Hey, this is Agent X. We're loitering here at Chaosome. We're here to see four bands here tonight. His Name Was Yesterday, As Forever Fades, Baron Mordo, and Beverly Hellfire. That's right, tonight we're talking to fans, we're talking to bands, doing some loitering, and we're here at Chaosome, and you're watching the Bare Bones Music Network. Let's get it started. This is the Evil G with the Bare Bones Music Network, and I'm sitting in the palatial tour van of His Name Was Yesterday. Well, I just can't say what you have all become. It's sick in me. Tell me, how's the tour gone so far and all your shows, and tell me about the EP and what your plans are right now.
Well, the tour's gone absolutely great, man. We actually had a real bad problem. We had our Josh right there broke his bass first night of tour. First night. His backup shits the bed a couple of nights later. And a guy named Mike Cameo, who's one of, he runs the Indies Top 10 out of Cincinnati, brought him a bass and gave it to him. It was pretty awesome. We've just had so much hospitality come to us. We've had people taking such good care of us. The venues have been outstanding. The people that we've met on the road have been awesome. It's been a great tour.
We've had friends like throw us extra cash for the road just because we're on the road. Right. People housing us up, feeding us. I mean, kind of reassures you that there's some good people still left around, you know?
What is His Name Is Yesterday all about?
Well, first off, I'm John. I sing. We are touring our Witness to a Dying World EP, produced by Doug White out of Watchmen Studios in Buffalo, New York. We are a Buffalo band. I love that we're out here that we're doing it. And it's a matter of putting in the work, running the gauntlet. I mean, we're living the dream, you know, one step at a time, one show at a time, and one interview at a time. We're stoked to be with you guys. We saw your STEM interview, and then it was, telling you, man, it was one of the best interviews we've ever seen, dude. It was awesome.
We've all got different influences in music. We all like a wide range of different stuff, and when we sit down to write, like, stuff just seems to flow like that. I mean, we've all got, like, our own. Everybody likes a bunch of bands together, and then everybody kind of ventures off and likes their own weird stuff that somebody will be like, dude, you're stupid for liking that band.
And I like Coldplay. I like Coldplay.
He's stupid for liking that band.
So like, it just kind of flows, and everybody just kind of, I don't know, man. Yeah, but you're right. I mean, we got that hard edge stuff, and we still got melodic stuff, and honestly, that's the type of stuff that most of us listen to collectively anyways. Yes. So that's how it kind of comes out, you know.
There's a very powerful balance between what is aggressive and what is singing. And a great example is All That Remains, the Killswitch Engage, the metalcore style. And like, I like that balance. I mean, fuck soil work, man. I mean, I like that we can be heavy, but we can still be melodic at the same time. And I think that how do you say it? That ambidextrousness, not a word, but I don't care, is something that we really like. I mean, it's good to have the heaviness, but at the same time to be able to sing, to be able to connect with people. And those hook parts are, you know, that people can sing, that get stuck in people's head. And that's one of the things we really gear our writing towards, is having those, you know, those melodic hooks and those melodic parts, you know. That's just part of what we do.
Agent X of BareBonesMusic.com here with Beverly Hellfire, and I'm guessing by the sweatiness, maybe you guys just played, am I right?
Ungodly hot in there.
Yeah, definitely hot. But you know, I'm not even so sure it's because of the lack of air conditioning. I think it was because of the heat that you guys. So obviously, you guys are used to playing bigger places than here. But how do you like playing a small club like this where the fans are up in your face?
It's definitely more intimate.
Awesome, awesome. They love it. It's like they're right there. It's like brutality.
Yeah. It's cool. Like big places, you're up there and you're all like, Then, like, places like this, everyone's all up in your face, and, you know, it's more intimate. It's cooler, you know? You feed off the energy, so.
You interact a lot more with the crowd, and it's just so much more fun. And just so they get to get into it more and everything, and it's really cool. So we like playing it.
How do you bring that same energy to the studio, or have you yet?
A little bit. We record pretty much everything ourselves. We ain't really done too much. We've only released, you know, a couple songs on the internet just to, you know, show what we're about. But as of right now, we're getting really good feedback. Like, we posted our songs up. And before we even played a show, we had, what was it, like 8,000?
Yeah, we had like 8,000 plays in just like months. Yeah, not even that long, really, more like a month. It was just awesome. We were surprised.
About 900 to 1,000 plays a day, so.
Excellent feedback so far. Yeah. Excellent.
Awesome. So you guys have plans just to, are you going to keep, you know, DIY, or are you guys going to get like a producer and all that and go into the studio, or?
Not really too much right now. Not really thinking that far ahead, but in the studio soon, some more stuff to come, brutality all the way.
Beverly Hellfire. Where'd that come from?
About 32 years ago, we're from Campbell County, Kentucky. There used to be a nightclub called the Beverly Hills Supper Club that burnt down, and like 180 something people got killed in it in our county. And basically, the way death metal is supposed to be is take the extreme and take it a step further. So that was kind of how we looked at it, and we just kind of did a play on the name of the place. So at Beverly Hell, we just kind of made up a list of names, and Beverly Hellfire was the one that stuck out the most. But that's where it came from. That was the influence, you know. I mean, we've always grew up listening to Cannibal, like death metal, like Cannibal Corpse. I grew up listening to Deicide ever since I was like 12, 13. And then BDM came out, and it's just like, whoa, we need to play that kind of music. And that just got us started in playing actual death metal. Cause we've been in bands before, but kind of on a lighter side, like metalcore and nu metal for some of us. So, yeah. So, yeah, it's definitely a change, but it's awesome, you know.